गुड मॉर्निंग माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टूडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट जेंडर. सो जेंडर ऑफ अ नाउन टेल्स अस वेदर इट इज अ मेल और अ फीमेल. सो नाउन्स कैन बी डिवाइडेड इंटू फोर जेंडर्स, मैस्कुलिन, फेमिनिन, कॉमन एंड न्यूटर. मैस्कुलिन नाउन्स दैट स्टैंड फॉर बॉयज, मेन एंड मेल एनिमल्स. For example, bridegroom, brother, father, tiger. These are masculine genders. Then feminine. Nouns that stand for girls, women and female animals are called feminine gender. For example, bride, sister, mother, tigress. Then common gender. Nouns that stand for either male or female are called common gender. For example, student, cousin, teacher, bird. These are common gender. Neuter, then neuter gender. Nouns that are names of non-living things and are neither masculine nor feminine. For example, table, chair, house, car, etc. So there are three ways of forming the feminine of nouns. Number one, by using an entirely different word, as bachelor, spinster, brother, sister, bull, cow, horse, mare, lord, lady, monk, nun, and etc. Number two, by adding a syllable like ess or ine or trix or a, etc. For example, author, authoress, count, countess, hero, heroine, sultan, sultana, fox, vixen, and Caesar, Caesarina. No, it will be zer and zerina because the pronunciation of c is omitted. Okay, next point, third number, by placing a word before or after, as manservant, maidservant, landlord, landlady, milkman, milkwoman, peacock, peahen, etc. Okay, students, now we will discuss simple present tense, simple past tense and present continuous tense. Okay, simple present tense. We use the simple present tense to speak about actions that are done as a habit or routine. For example, John goes to the gym every day. Or I drink a glass of milk every morning. So it is a habit or routine. Then we use simple present tense to speak about universal truths. For example, the earth revolves around the sun, the moon moves around the earth. So these are the universal truths. Next, statements that are always true. For example, cows moo, bees sting. Okay, then events, actions and situations without any time reference. For example, I love walnut muffins. Or Mahesh lives in Kerala. Okay, we often use time expressions like always, every day, never, usually, generally, hardly, rarely, sometimes, seldom, with the simple present tense. Okay, now simple past tense. We use the simple past tense to speak about actions that started and finished as a at a specific time in the past. For example, he went for a walk at 10 p.m. last night. Or I got his letter a week ago. So when past time is mentioned, we use simple past tense. Past time means yesterday, a week ago, last night. These are the time expressions. So you have to keep in mind that to express past actions when the past time is not mentioned, we use present perfect tense. And to express past actions when the past time is mentioned, we use simple past tense. So this is very important, that when past time is mentioned, we use simple past tense. When past time is not mentioned, we use present perfect tense. Okay, second point. To express past habits, we use simple past tense. This is also indicated by the use of used to before the verb. For example, he used to write to his friend every week. Or he used to go for a holiday every year. Okay, third point is to express historical events, we use simple past tense. So whether a past time is mentioned or not, we don't need to see that. So events or actions or situations that happened a very long time ago, it is a history, so we use simple past tense. For example, Vasco da Gama arrived in Calicut in 1498. Then Tagore lived in Calcutta. Then India achieved independence in 1947. So these are the historical events, they can't change it. So always use simple past tense with for expressing historical events. Okay, now present continuous tense. Sentences that tell us about actions that are happening at the time of speaking are said to be in the present continuous tense. We use am, is, are and the present participle to express this tense. For example, I am going to the library in the afternoon, or Mohit and Suraj are going to the zoo. Okay, now I am giving you a list of verbs which we cannot use in any of the continuous tenses. They are also called non-conclusive verbs. Number one, verbs of mental activity like suppose, remember, forget, believe, agree, trust, know, understand, mean, recognize, defer, doubt, find, imagine. So do not say I am forgetting your name. It is absolutely wrong. Then verbs of feeling and emotion like love, wish, desire, like, prefer, hate, want, need. So you cannot say he was wanting to know the answer. It is absolutely incorrect. You can say he wanted to know the answer, but he was wanting, he was preferring, it is absolutely incorrect. Then verbs of perception. The verbs are notice, hear, feel, smell, see. So do not say I am seeing someone through the window, but I am not hearing him clearly. It is incorrect construction. Then belong, have, possess, own. So these are the verbs we cannot use in continuous tense. So do not say this car is belonging to me. It is wrong. When the verb have means possession, we cannot use continuous tense. But when the verb have does not mean to possess, then we can use continuous tenses. For example, my mother is having a rest now. So it does not mean possession. It means my mother is taking rest now. Okay, now when the verb look means to see, we can use continuous tenses with this verb. For example, he is looking at the sunset now. But when look means appearance, we cannot use continuous tenses. For example, that sari is looking very good on you. It is wrong. it because it means appearance. So these are the things you have to keep in mind. If you have any question, you can ask me.